Unfortunately, most psychiatrists will simply get a diagnosis based on symptoms, categorize the patient, which for my purposes is basically just for insurance purposes, because it doesn't tell you anything about what's really going on, and then writes a prescription. And I think that's ridiculous because that's not addressing the root cause of the problem. It would be like the light goes on your dashboard, and you go to the mechanic, and he puts a Band-Aid over it and sends you on your way.
These drug companies that I was interviewing with had no problem telling me, look, we design drugs based on treating symptoms. We don't cure. So that's a business model, okay, that allows you to give a drug to a person for life. There's two words that a psychiatrist fears. Two words. Prove it.
It was immediately obvious to me that the psychiatrists were making claims that they couldn't have made, that they were making claims which simply were not justified in biology. But if you stand up and say that what you're doing, ladies and gentlemen, is not science, it's pseudoscience, then you are challenging what's holding the whole profession together. What's happening in psychiatry is that there is a general agreement there will be no criticism of the status quo. There will be no criticism. They just make this claim, mental disease is brain disease. But that, as I've said, is an ideological claim. I think secretly they know deep inside, if anybody criticizes this or examines this too closely, it might fall apart.
The truth is, we cannot tell who is mentally ill and who is not by looking at pictures of their brains or analyzing their blood. Psychiatrists had to invent their own book of diseases because pathologists would have nothing to do with them. It's called the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual for Mental Disorders, the DSM, a great work of fiction. What's the difference? What's the difference between the DSM and a scientific book of disease? Every disorder in the DSM is invented. Every disease listed in a pathology textbook is discovered. Real disease is found in a cadaver at autopsy. Mental illness is not.
When I went to medical school, there were only 6 or 7 items in the manual. Now there are over 300. I mean, you mean to tell me that there have been 294 diseases discovered in the last 60 years? In psychiatry alone? It's a joke. It's an epidemic of psychiatry that we are dealing with. We don't have an epidemic of mental illness, we have an epidemic of psychiatry. No free will, it's all chemicals. No self-discipline, no self-control. Nobody has yet measured, demonstrated, or created a test to show that somebody has a chemical imbalance in their brain. Period.
I have a real problem, not only with the diagnosis, but certainly with the drugs and the effects that they can have on these children. These drugs, according to the drug manufacturers, can cause psychosis, can cause worsening and behavior problems, can cause heart attacks and other cardiac symptoms, and there have been many deaths.